Last week I made all of you rich, am I right?
I
asked you how many of you are rich, and some of you are still thinking. Three times I had to ask you how many of you are rich, and then slowly, slowly hands were coming up, and last you all said you are rich.
Amen.
God's word tells us we are all rich in Christ. But today's message is not about the richness. It's about some concern. So from a high preaching, we come to a kind of a low preaching today. Today is a bit more seriousness in our lives. Because we're not going to go on like this all the time. We need to have an emoji check at the end of the year. How is our life? Are we a lapsed Christian or are we a growing Christian? So let's look at the concern of the Apostle Paul for the church in Galatia. Chapter 4, verse number 19. It says like this, my little children for whom I labor in birth again until Christ is formed in you. We have come to the season of celebrating Christmas, the birth of Jesus. And hardly many people, they ever think about Jesus at Christmas time. But let us make it clear to everyone out there in the world, Jesus was born. He was born of a virgin. And he came for us to redeem us from our sins. In this chapter 4, there are two kinds of birth mentioned. In chapter 4, verse 4, it's, Paul writes, in the fullness of time, he's talking about the birth of Jesus Christ. It says that God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law. To redeem those who are under the law. That we might receive the adoption of sons and daughters. That is the birth of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus was born, we don't have to be born under any bondage.
Hallelujah.
And you can be born free. But Paul is secondly discussing about another birth here. That's what we read in chapter 4 of Galatians verse 19. And he wants that same Christ to be born in the hearts of the believers. And until that happens, you are not a believer in Jesus. Many people call themselves Christians. They don't have Christ inside of them. That is very sad indeed. If you ask many people now, what is Christmas all about? You will see an average population will say Christmas is a time to drink plenty of alcohol. Others will say Christmas is a white man's festival. Politically correctness, they say Christmas is winter fest. There is no mention about Jesus anywhere. But we have determined to put Jesus back in Christmas.
पैर दिलाएंगे।
The government is taking Christ out of Christmas।
इस मुल्क की सरकार यीशु की पदाइश जन्म क्रिसमस को बाहर कर रही है।
And the people, general populace, they're taking Christ out of Christmas and instead they're putting alcohol inside।
दुनिया के आम लोग मसीह यीशु की पदाइश को बाहर कर देने पार्टियां शराबा नशा नहीं रख रहे।
But we must put Christ where He belongs। You can can buy the cheapest one, £2 from the Southall Broadway.
And
it will last for a little while. You can buy from eBay or Amazon, you can buy these kind of things for a very cheap price. But I've never seen the original one. Until we went to, when we were in the Philippines, I wanted to buy a good one, so I went to one of the shops. And boy, that is original. That cover fell from, that phone fell from my hand many times on the floor. Not even a scratch is on that cover. You just have to keep white, keep it clean, and it will remain as new as it is.
And
that is original. The gospel in its originality, Paul preached to the Galatian Christians. But it seems somebody else came and brought another gospel to them. The true gospel is a salvation in Jesus' name only. You don't need to do any more work. It is not Jesus plus or Jesus minus, Jesus and Jesus Him only. Some people, I think, Brother Jimmy and some of us know, some people believe Jesus plus another prophet. The Mormons believe Jesus plus Joseph Smith. And there are so many people add to it and they take out of it. It seems the Galatian Christians were told, not only the New Testament gospel, you need to follow some of the Old Testament traditions as well.
Also,
I'm concerned about you.
Concern.
How dare you go back to something old which you left and came back? There are so many gospels we can hear nowadays. There is a prosperity gospel. And they say that if you are a Christian, you want to be a rich person. It is a lying gospel, it's not the gospel of Jesus. Many prosperity preachers in America buying many, many jets. Now they have no parking places, they are buying many more jets. Let me please tell you, don't follow these prosperity preachers. Your money should not be sent to any of these prosperity preachers.
And
the Bible clearly says there were poor saints in Jerusalem. And Paul took a collection from Thessalonica to feed the poor saints of God. The true prosperity is the prosperity of the gospel which is in our hearts and spirits. So don't follow any prosperity gospel preachers. Paul was concerned about it.
So Paulus no Galatia di Kalisia wale fikr lag gaya.
He was moving into another gospel.
Eh prabhu main hairan ho gaya. Sachi shiksha lage tusi jhooti shiksha de piche lag gaya.
The second concern Paul had.
Paulus da dusra concern ya fikr.
Galatians chapter 4.
Galatia di kitab chautha chapter.
Verse number 9.
Novi verse.
Here they're turning to a weaker or a weaker kind of element which is going back to the Old Testament. They are going into rituals and sacrifices of the Old Testament.
But
Paul writes here. Galatians 4:9 says, but now after you have known God, or rather are known by God, how is it that you turn again to the weak and beggarly elements to which you desire again to be in bondage? serve days and months and seasons and years. Verse 11, I am afraid for you, lest I have labored for you in vain. Christians, is there any concern in your faith, in your practice? You know, if you come from another religion or another sect of the Christian Christian denomination, do you have a temptation to go back to the old one? For example, if you come out from a Mormonism, do you still have an affection for Joseph Smith? Or if you come out from Roman Catholicism, do you still pray through Mary? But God's word says only one mediator, that is Jesus Christ. We must never pray through Mary or Joseph or anyone. Well, I heard some people say, I'm born as a Catholic, I will die as a Catholic. Well, that is your, that's your choice. But God's word says God is concerned about you. Don't go back to the old ones. If you're born again by the Spirit of God, He must walk in the Spirit. And as I wrote in the bulletin today, flow in the Spirit. And that's what God wants us to be like. He says that you want to go back to the old tradition. And that's a concern God has about some Christians. Which is bigger? My tradition or my Jesus? I chose to follow Jesus. I got rid of all my bad traditions. If you are still keeping on some of the unwanted traditions, you cannot enter God's kingdom. It is serious business, brothers and sisters. God is going to judge you and me not based on our tradition but based on the word of God. Look at the third concern. Chapter 4, verse number 20. Paul speaking very serious words here. He says, I would like to be present with you now and to change my tone.
और इस तरह बोला
he is very serious here now.
बड़ा गंभीर है.
He says, for I have doubts about you.
मैं दुविधा में क्या हां तुम्हारे बारे में शक है.
He is writing to Christians in Galatia.
गलातिया के चर्च को खत लिखे है उसे गला लिखा है.
And they were born again before.
उन्होंने नवा जन्म पाया रूह के लोक में आत्मा वाले लोक में फिर भी.
Now Paul says, I have doubts about you.
बस तुम किस तरह मैंने तुम्हारे शक हुआ.
Will you make it to heaven? Just because you went through the water baptism, just because your name is in the church register, and just because you give to charity, it doesn't take you to heaven. It is your life that is in line with God's word and in the Spirit of God. When God looks at you and me today, is God saying, Joe, I have doubts about you, man? If God tells that to me, or when I know, when I read God's word, I know I'm a guilty person, I will correct myself. Because I want to be when the trumpets are sound. When the dead in Christ shall rise, if I'm dead, I want to rise again. I don't want to be left out in this world. Because the Antichrist is about to take over. These concerns Paul has. There is one more I mentioned and I'm going to Look at chapter 5, verse number 7. Another concern Paul has for Christians in Galatia. That they stop growing. He says, You ran well. Who hindered you from obeying the truth? Now you look at yourself, you were running well once upon a time. And how are you running now? I'm not talking about running in the tracks. The Southall Park, I used to run for a few rounds. I used to run for a few times. And there was a very old man, he used to run about 15 rounds. So as we are jogging, we'll ask him how many times. He will just show his hands, punch. And he still keep running. And I said, man, I'm much younger than him, but I could run like him. We don't see him in the park anymore. I think he's dead and gone. But when I go now, I wanted to beat him in the 15 runs. Guess what? When I make about 2 runs, I'm just tired. So instead of the run, I go to the slow walk now. I don't know what's going to be next. Now I'm walking, maybe I'm just crawling next time. I don't know. So I'm asking myself, you are running well before. Physically, because of my body cannot keep up, that's why I'm running slow now. Let's be serious, talk about spiritually. You are really enthusiastic in studying the word, praying, you know, attending services. What hindered you now? You have to answer the question. I used to be so enthusiastic for Jesus. Now I'm a backslider. That is very dangerous ground to stand on a backslider. That means if Christ comes, you are still a backslider. You'll be left out in the world. Jesus is coming for a spotless and a wrinkleless
bride.
Did you know that? Christ is not coming to take all the Christians to heaven, by the way. Many who call themselves Christians will be left out. Only those who are sealed by the blood of Jesus. Only those who are indwelt and filled with the Holy Spirit. Only those who are living in the light of God's word. Only the bride of Christ will be there in heaven. It is very serious, brothers and sisters. If you were running well before, and if you're running slow now, you're not running at all. Paul has great concern about you. Let me say three things quickly as I close. In the midst of all these concerns, the essence of Paul's message is this. I am in labor pain. Christ will be born in you. Until he is born in you, I am in labor pain. What does that mean? We need to have God's favor for God, Jesus, to be born in us. Morning service, we heard an excellent message from Reverend
Jayachandra.
And he was referring to the scripture which I'm going to read it again. Luke's Gospel chapter 1 verses 26 onwards. It's about the birth of Jesus. The announcement given to Mary. And when you look at verse number 27 onwards, towards the last letter, the virgin's name was Mary. 28, and having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." This young woman was called out of the blue by the angels and God's favor is upon you. Then he goes on to say in verse number 31, the angel said, "Behold, you will conceive in your womb a virgin, and he bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus." Christ to be born in you. You need to have the favor of God. Do you have the favor of God today? The answer is yes, His favor is upon you. Even the very reason you're sitting in this church is God's favor is upon you. And the second thing you need is you need to have a faith in Jesus. To accept what the angel said. Look at Luke 1 verse 38. Mary tried to say, "I don't know a man, so how can I give birth to a child?" But with God, all things are possible. He must listen very carefully, verse 38. Then Mary said, "Behold the maidservant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." You need to accept what God says. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And you will be saved. For Christ to be born in you, you need to accept the word of God. If you reject what God said in His word, Christ cannot be born in you. Peter the Apostle tells us, you are born again by the word of God. Not just by having an emotion. Not just because somebody pushed you into the church. God's favor is upon you. And you accepted the word as it is. And that's how Christ is born in you. Last two verses and I'm closing. Look at Ephesians chapter 3 verse number 17. You must not only have the favor of God, not only accept it by your faith in Christ, you must advance in the faith. Ephesians is a prayer, chapter 3, verse 17 onwards. And this prayer is for a spiritual in-depth knowledge and growth. Look at what Paul says, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. Let me ask you this question. Is Christ in your mind only or in your heart? Many philosophers can debate about Christ. That's a mental exercise. But God is not very much pleased with that. The Christ may dwell not in your mind but in your heart. That knowledge you receive by reading and watching and listening, it should come down in your heart.
Jo samajh, jo budh, jo akal, Khuda da kalam sun ke si paunya, sare man vich ni baat ke dilan vich karan pravaj vaas se chahiye.
Last words, Colossians 1:27.
Kaliser kitab, dusra pehla chapter.
Colossians chapter 1 verse 27.
Puri sari ayat mein ko Bible mein kya likha hai?
This is the prayer and the burden of the apostle Paul.
Ye jo dua hai, prarthna hai, ya bojh hai jo Paulus sochte le raha hai.
To them God will to make known that are the riches of the glory of this mystery.
Ye prabhu ki ichha thi ki apni mehma, apna pet, apna tan, apne logon ne jahir kare.
The mystery among the Gentiles.
Ye kya roma mein jis masih ne pet ho khole.
And what is the mystery?
Aur masih ne aaj ki pet hai.
Christ in you.
Masih Yesu tode vich vasna hai.
The hope of glory.
Jo wo ameer hai, jo mehma aur glory hai.
Christ in me.
Masih Yesu mere andar hai.
Until Christ is born in you.
Jab tak masih Yesu mere dil vich, meri zindagi vich nahi hai.
Paul is in labor pain.
Padus nu ek janam de mein peeda lagi honi
hai. Until the preachers and the leaders and the pastors will be in labor pain.
Jede preacher ne, pracharak ne, padri ne, unna nu ye peeda lag rahi
hai. Until Christ is deeply rooted in your heart.
Jab tak masih Yesu janam de mein sade dil vich, sade zindagi vich nahi paida hunda.
I see in many churches around this area.
मैं बहुत सारे चर्चा से ऐसे देखता
हूं. Many people are not truly Christians.
बहुत सारे लोग सच्चे मसीह नहीं हैं.
When the mela comes, they are there.
जब मेला आ रहा है तो फिर सारी संगता वहां है.
When there is a wrong kind of crowd comes with a wrong kind of prayer, they are there.
जब हो गई मौत मौत में स्थिति होती है सारे लोग खड़े होते
हैं. I know they don't stand out for the word of God.
परमेश्वर के वचन ही प्रभु की वाणी ही कोई नहीं खराब होना चाहिए.
It doesn't mean you should not mix with non-Christians, no.
ऐहो जवानी के सी उन्हें लोगों ने मिक्स ना होइए.
When it comes to your devotion and your practice of your faith, you must stand out for Jesus.
जो तुम्हारी अपनी जिंदगी की सच्चाई या विश्वास की गलत है उस पे खड़े रहो.
And if you're shying about the word of God and the name of Jesus.
अगर तुम यीशु के नाम को शर्माने हो और जाओ ये वचन तो शर्माओगे.
He says that I will be shying away when on the judgment comes.
परवाना उस दिन मैं स्वर्ग दूत के सामने तोड़ा भी निकाल कर.
We must stand for Jesus.
आओ प्रभु प्रभु अपने मसीहा ले खड़े हो जाइए.
Last night, my wife, Simone and myself, we went to a Tamil Christian carol service in Milton
Keynes.
There were quite a few families came. They asked me to give a Christmas message. And I didn't care who was sitting there. I wanted to lift up the name of Jesus. I tell you, I had a captive audience there.
ते एहो जे ऑडियंस सन बैठे चार चीज लोग.
I said three or four things from the scriptures.
मैं बाइबल की आयत का जो तीन चार हवाले दे.
What is true Christmas?
सच्ची जैसे ही क्रिसमस की है.
So as they came out of the pulpits.
जो पुलपुट को बाहर आए.
A Hindu couple came to me.
एक हिंदू जोड़ा मेरे को आया.
He said that was wonderful.
कहने के बहुत सारा मैसेज देता
है. We never heard anything like this.
अच्छी एहो जे मैसेज के लिए सुने.
And they said you made it simple even for the children.
और बच्चे ने समझ ला दी.
I said I was speaking to the children now. Anyway, there are a lot of kids staying there. And I tell you, they all got a message yesterday. But my intention was to lift up that name of Jesus above all other things. There was a big party going on. There was lots of performances there. But my concern was at least one person will hear the gospel.
एक इंसान प्रभु का वचन सुन ले.
Until Christ is born in you.
जब तक यीशु साथ में पैदा नहीं होगा.
Is that your desire?
कि ये तुम्हारी चाहत है.
Is Christ really in me fully?
कि साथ में यीशु मसीह का दिल है.
Oh Christ only quarter of my heart.
जब तुम्हारे दिल से थोड़ा जाए.
Is some of your heart only 50% Christ in you?
तो की तुम्हारा दिल 50% यीशु में है.
Many of us are Sunday Christians.
सारे जो बोलते हैं संडे वाले मसीह लोग
हैं. I mean in the sense that I'm not talking about people who go to work. No.
मैं उन लोगों की बात करता हूं जो जॉब आने संडे
को. We only worship on Sundays.
और संडे में सिर्फ इबादत होती है.
Do you worship when you're driving?
जब कार चला रहे हो कि यीशु को दिल से प्यार
दे रहे हो. Do you worship when you're walking?
जब चलते चलते प्रभु यीशु याद कर
रहे हो. Do you pray when you're at your workplace?
प्रार्थना कर रहे हो काम पे हो.
Do you give thanks to God when you're at home?
प्रभु का धन्यवाद कर रहे हो जो कार हो.
There are many many things you can do.
बहुत सारे काम में मसीह करो.
If Christ is born in you.
अगर यीशु का दिल से प्यार है.
you will have the reflection of Christ. That which is born of the flesh is flesh.
जो शरीर को पैदा है वो शरीर है.
But that which is born of the spirit is spirit.
जो आत्मा को पैदा है वो आत्मा.
I thank God for the name of Jesus.
मैं धन्यवाद करना पिता और बेटे यीशु.
Your prayers are important.
तुम्हारी दुआ प्रार्थना जरूरी है.
In this building, as you will see throughout the week, deliverance is taking place.
इस बिल्डिंग बहुत सारे लोगों ने छुटकारा मिल रहा है.
Through the Jesus calls, many non-Christians and Roman Catholics coming and finding Christ.
Jesus called missionaries द्वारा Roman Catholic जंतुसियों को मांचो लोग आ रहे हैं.
And we are the recipients of the blessings.
और सानू ये बर्ता आशीष प्रभु को मिल गया है.
And we're dealing with couples because of the demonic possession.
और बहुत सारे कारावास के लोग हैं भूत पे इतने बदरुहा हैं.
The other day when we were praying together, I read from the scripture.
मैं बाइबल जो पढ़िया दुआ कर रहे थे.
I let the demon hear in the lady's ears.
मैं उस हॉल जी शैतान ने जबरी उसे उन
I said, so shall my word be.
कि मेरा वचन ये आता है प्रभु आता है.
That comes out of my mouth, God says.
प्रभु आता है जो मेरा वचन तेरे मुंह से
निकला. It shall not come back to me empty.
खाली वापस नहीं आएगा.
It will accomplish what I purpose it for.
जिस काम में अपना वचन ने कहा पूरा होता है.
Until Christ is born in you.
जो तक यीशु परिचय.
Christmas is coming.
Christmas आ रही है.
We will be too busy.
असी बहुत बिजी हो जाएंगे.
Make sure Christ is deep inside.
यादव को यीशु का दिल में गहराइयां बनाइयां
इस पैरा. Father, let's pray.
आइए अपने सर्वोच्च चाय और